All right, here we go. It's the last train to Clarksburg, so I'll see you at the station. I don't understand how I have a fucking bounty. A wanted dead or alive thing is kind of nauseating.
Okay, fella.
Can I even go that way?
Morning, Arthur.
Morning, Arthur.
You okay, Jack?
Is Mr. Strauss gone?
Okay, I'll catch you later then.
Sure, Uncle Arthur.
It's really sad.
That's my boy.
Good job, horse.
Trying to rob a sick man?
I was trying to help.
Bullshit you was.
I hope you move, fancy boots. Unlike you, I'm honorable.
Eat shit and die. Oh, you don't want to die. Okay. How about now?
How's you bastards? like more than that, boy.
Here you are, boy.
Yeah, you all right there, boy?
Yeah.
Natural rock formation, just kind of there.
Okay there, boy.
Okay there.
You okay, boy? Okay there.
And this is where it goes, but I need to get out of there faster. This place is.
Good boy. Yeah. Easy there.
Who's called them? It's starting to hurt. Take those off.
Good boy. Good boy.
Damn it, now I need my glasses again. What am I looking at out here? Out here.
Yep. Yep.
Yep.
Are you kidding me?
Easy, boy. Gotta be done.
Trying to get perfect stuff.
Come on, pal.
Painfully obvious that. Cannot move that way. Sell it?
Easy, easy.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Whoa, boy, easy. Yeah.
How? What is the game trying to tell me here?
Thank you. on, boy. Stay.
Better safe than sorry, am I right?
Apparently nothing happened.
Come on now, boy.
Star knows how to build a world, yeah. And that.
Yeah, you all right there, boy? There we go. Easy now.
Doing.
Okay then.
Mister?
This is no place for you.
Gentlemen?
Why have you come here?
Stranger speaks to rain and fog.
Hey there, mister!
He's supporting us? Even with the supplies, the portions will be...
Hey, mister!
Some graphics, right?
You don't sound very well.
I'm not. I think I'm dying.
Then I hope you find peace.
Well, I don't know too much about peace.
Apparently not. Did you have fun with my son, the impetuous prince? I believe you went on a raid with him.
I'm sorry.
I suppose I lack the grandeur of a conventional king.
I don't know too many kings.
Colonel Favors, he has already exacted some measure of revenge for the raid. Two women were assaulted by his men.
I'm very sorry about all of this.
Yes. Sometimes the correct path, the bravest path, is the least obvious. And also the gentlest. I'm a great disappointment to my son.
Your son seems to want a war.
My son thinks there is glory in death. Maybe he's right. But for me, I saw death being handed out so freely by the most foolish of men, I never could equate it with victory. glory has come in service. Maybe. Maybe not, I don't know.
I've killed a lot of people. For a whole lot of dumb reasons, and I ain't never seen much glory in it.
Well, your friend, Mr. Vanderlyn, he talks a lot. I don't know him, but my son is easily led.
I'm not sure I get you.
Perhaps we could go for a ride. I'm an old man. My whole life I have tried to bring peace.
But I ain't doing so good.
Then maybe you can take pity on my plight. Please, it won't take long. And maybe I can help you with that cough.
Sir! I'm glad I caught you, sir.
Captain Monroe, do you know my friend, Mr. Morgan?
No, sir. I don't have the pleasure.
Arthur Morgan.
It's an honor, sir.
How can I help you, Captain?
I was just in Saint-Denis. I spoke with the mayor. It's not good news, I'm afraid. May I ride with you for a little?
Of course.
Follow me.
So where are we going?
I want to show you a site up in the mountains that's long been sacred to me. A place for reflection and healing. What is this news, Captain Monroe?
Yes, sir. As I mentioned, I did speak again with the mayor and the Bureau of Indian Affairs in Saint-Denis at length. But regrettably, it appears the oil company has already received approval to move forward with drilling on the reservation's land.
I suppose there's much. So what does that mean for us now?
I'm not sure just yet. I didn't get the impression anything would be happening for a few months. I'm very sorry, sir. I did everything I could.
I know, Captain.
And I assure you I will continue to do as much as I can. Mr. Morgan, would you have time to help me at all? I would rather certain actions were taken by friends outside the tribe.
Sure, I can help.
That's good news. Thank you. Come meet me on the reservation whenever you can. I'm sorry to be forward, but there's so much to be done. Anyway, gentlemen, I won't take up any more of your time. I'll see you both soon.
Sure.
Thank you, Captain.
Enjoy the ride.
We'll continue on this way. I'm going to look for some herbs to give you. See past our own grievances. This is what I try to teach my son.
Yeah! Go on, get out of here!
Good. There was no need to harm them.
Easy now.
If you want, Mr. Morgan. But don't feel like you have to. It's a beautiful ride ahead if you need some time to think.
So, we don't know each other too well, but I wanted to speak to you about your son. I was there on the raid to steal back those horses, and, well, you know something of Dutch, I think.
Yes, a little. Mostly. Sorry, hold up a moment. That'll have to wait. Some of the plants I need will be growing down here. Mace. Okay. Let's continue on. So back to what I was talking about. Yes, a little. Mostly from your friend Charles.
I don't know why Dutch is getting involved in your situation, and this ain't easy to say, but I just don't trust that he's got your son's best interests at heart.
So what can we do?
I don't rightly know. Charles and I just thought you should be aware. Maybe there's a way to stop things from getting any more out of control.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. Let me give this some thought.
You know, I had a son once, years ago. Don't talk about him much.
No, what was his name?
Isaac. His mother, Eliza, the waitress I met. When she got pregnant, she knew who I was, what my life was. I didn't want to promise nothing I couldn't keep, but I said I'd do right by them. Every few months, I'd stop by there for a few days. He was such a good kid. She was too, I guess. Just a kid, 19.
What happened?
I got there one day and saw two crosses outside. I knew right away.
Wait, stop here. I want to pick some ginseng. We can talk more about this later. This will combine well. Much further now.
Now, I was saying, turned out some bastards had come through. Robbed them, shot them dead, and offered $10. Hardened me, feeling that kind of pain. But I know now that you don't get to live a bad life and have good things happen to you.
I think you're being hard on yourself.
Maybe. All I can do now is try and make some things right. I appreciate the herbs, but I think it's gonna take more than that. I saw a doctor, and he says I'm in a pretty bad way.
I'm sorry to hear that.
This situation we're in, me, Dutch, and the others, I don't know how long I got, but some of them, they still got a chance to have a life. I just think it, if I could give them that, then maybe this ain't all for nothing.
I think there is much you can still do, Mr. Morgan.
Okay there, boy.
Just up ahead. What's happened?
No!
It can't be.
No! They've destroyed everything! No, I need to find the Chinupa.
Who would do this? Someone who wanted to enrage you. Help me look around, please. The Chinupa is gone.
Of course. What is it?
A ceremonial pipe. There must be some clues to what happened here.
There's some whiskey here.
Okay. Let me give this some more thought. Thank you, Mr. Morgan.
Looks like they're doing some drinking.
Bottle of whiskey.
Well, if they drank all that, they couldn't have gotten too far.
Yeah, well, still no sign of the Chinupa.
There's some logs here they must have used as kindling.
Do you have any binoculars? Oh, there they are. These brave men. Some of Colonel Favor's men. They must have been the ones who did this.
Are you surprised this happened?
Not at all. But... but I hope we were past this.
Well, you got land they want. Land with oil.
They moved us here. They've taken everything we had. I signed 3 treaties myself, and they've broken each one. No, they've taken the last hope. Now my people are going to want a war. A war they can't win.
Not if I get it back.
Get it back?
Yeah, I'm gonna go in, get your chin up, and no one will be any the wiser.
Would you do that?
Well, you can't go. They know why you'd come.
I don't have any money.
No, I don't need your money.
Please see if they have our sacred items. But try not to hurt anyone.
I'll try to ensure that they never even know I'm there, but actions don't always go the way you plan.
Okay, fella. Yep.
Silly though.
I know. Who wants to fight them? Who cares?
My uncle married an Indian anyway. She seemed nice enough.
An Indian?
Sure looked like one. From up near the Canadian border someplace.
Canada? They got Indians in Canada.
Tons of them. And French folk too.
France near Canada, then?
No. France is near... is near France. Well, it's in France. Indians is from here.
Where are you from?
Me? I'm Polish. From Milwaukee.
Hmm. Fellers! Over! Hey!
Look, Ma, no face. Well, I tried. Did my best.
Found it.
Here. I got your things, I think.
Yes. Thank you.
I'm very sorry about this.
Even sacred things are only things. People, the heart, matter more. Was anyone hurt?
Yes.
It's a bad business. I should not have let you do this for me, but perhaps it will stop a bigger massacre. With these, maybe I can calm my people. Maybe I can calm my son.
I hope so.
Thank you.
Take those herbs I gave you, please. And most of all, I hope you can find peace within yourself.
He's a man who, not so long ago, I would have found weak and pathetic. Now I see as wise and thoughtful and sensible. I would love to help him. Or at least stop Dutch pushing his son to do something real stupid. Easy now. Load up. Hamish.
Arthur. Come in.
You said, we could go for a hunt.
I did. There's this huge she-wolf been stalking me the last few nights I've been out, but she can wait. Let's talk a while.
Sure.
So what do you do?
Me? I'm a wanderer. I was born further north, but I spent a lot of time out west. Funny. I never saw myself as a wandering man. But...
The bodies lay so thick, you could have walked across the whole field without your boots touching mud.
Those were bad times.
Yes, they were. Would you like some more coffee?
Please.
What have we here? Yeah, she's right across there.
That close.
Oh, she's acting brazen. Come on, let's mount up.
Come on. She went around to the left, around the lake. She's down here somewhere. Keep up. Gotta get her while she's here.
Wolves shouldn't come so close to people.
Yeah, it's strange. When the whole country was wild, they could go where they liked. Now they're stuck hiding in the few corners of wilderness we got left.
It's a feeling with which I can sympathize.
This ain't a country for wild animals, nor wild men, neither.
Not anymore, it seems. Yep.
Quickly now. This way. Up there. On the outcrop, you see her? Let's go around it.
Okay, I'm with you.
on to her. Come on.
Okay.
Damn! I can't see her. Let's get up to the top. Have a look around from up there. View loves hills, don't you, boy? You eat them up for breakfast.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
What we got here? Is that a fresh kill?
Could be. Is the blood set?
Let me take a look.
Yep. That was her dinner. Now, where'd she get to? My guess. She's gone somewhere over there.
Well, there's a whole lot of over there.
That's... There she is. Got shy all of a sudden. You got some extra miles in you tonight?
Oh, if we gotta chase her, let's chase her.
All right. Come on.
Yep.
Better to be on foot. Sit your horse somewhere safe.
Get going, boy. There's a wolf about.
You went in there, all right. We got a tracker. Now you want to take the lead, or shall I?
If you don't mind, I'd like to.
Okay, get tracking. I'll be close behind you.
I got the trail. This way.
Right behind you. Take it slow. You see anything yet?
Just tracks.
Heading down here?
We don't get her. Well, what's the worst that can happen? She runs off with the chicken?
Well, I'm fine with losing chickens, but I lost a leg already. And I gotta pull down my pants to shit in these woods, so...
Yeah, you don't want to lose that.
Hey, up there! Is that the she-wolf? Ready to offer my complete and unconditional.
Yeah, I don't think the wolves would have shown much mercy.
That's quite an ambush she led us into.
Yeah, bushwhacking, I'd call it.
Huh? Goddamn! Over here! Over here!
Damn you! Monster!
big son of a bitch.
Is that all of them?
That's the best of them. Look at them. Proud thing.
Scary thing. They brought us here to be slaughtered.
You were after a hunt.
Yeah. Yeah, and I guess I got hunted. You going back to the cabin?
Nah. Still early. We'll stay up here a while. Dress this animal. Won't likely see another like him for some time.
Yeah, I hope I won't either. Thanks for taking me out.
Yeah, anytime. You want to go out again? You come by and see me.
So long, then.
Wait. Here's a pelt.
Thank you.
You earned it. So long. Speak stories he'd tell. What kind of wolf you gotta be to get this big?
Take long, boy.
Almost a shame we killed it.
You're right. We should have let it kill us. Puppy dog, you didn't eat all your food. Come on, come lay down. Come on, get up here. We're actually really close to home.
time. Rotten pig fucker. Never did no right by me. Not since I was six.
Well, glad you're feeling so good about all this.
Hey, he brought this on his damn self. Where my fault his brain got handled by damn demons.
Goddamn hillbillies.
Yep.
You okay, boy? Whoa, easy. There, boy. Yeah. Easy. Slow up now. Yeah. Easy, boy.
Who is that?
Man coming in.
Good to see you back, Arthur.
Hi, Karen.
Arthur Morgan.
Received anything from you in a while, Mr. Morgan.
I will. Looking pretty well stocked now. Fine, but make sure you get a good price for it.
Good job, Mr. Morgan. How are you on space in that bag of yours, Mr. Morgan? Just let me know if you need me to make you a new one.
Thank you.
That'll make everyone happy, I'm sure of it.
Guess we'll see if anyone notices. Here, let's get. Come on.
That's right.
Come on now, boy.
My brothers might be able to help you. I got you.
Yep.
Finally.
Be gone, sir. Be gone. Not because we cares not. No, but because we cares.
What are you talking
the
about?
Demons have us by the throat, sir. The darkness. The darkness, it's everywhere. He was right.
What are you talking about?
They come in darkness.
Somebody please help.
They're coming.
Stay inside. Keep your door shut. Stay. Don't. Stay down. Ma'am, safe now. See if there's any more of them. Shit, there's more, all right. Thank you.
Where?
Over there!
Alright, I'll handle this.
Come on!
Get yourselves home.
No. He said they would come in many forms. and he said his protection would come in many forms.
What are you talking about? It's just sick dogs. Hydrophobia or some other poison.
He said we were not to doubt him.
No. Get your people home, mister. Then get yourself a gun and kill any sick animals you see. Life will be just fine.
Darkness has come for us. Yeah, he was right.
Who was right?
I was.
Oh, Texas, from us. Protect us from the evil.
I shall save them.
Who are you?
There'll be no more four-legged demons. The curse shall change. The curse has changed.
What curse?
These poor people. I will save you.
I just saved them, and it weren't no curse. It's just sick dogs.
Dark charms possess the woods, I told you.
He told me he did. He told me.
I found one. Don't touch
it. He found the curse!
Found it. So?
The woods are full of these. While they remain, the curse will remain.
Oh, the curse!
Yet the woods are also full of demons. I will find a way. Have I lied to you thus?
He never lied to me.
Come, Obadiah. Feed me.
So, you're saying if someone destroys those charms, the curse is lifted?
The woods are full of demons. And the demons protect the charms. And the charms protect the demons. It's impossible.
I can see that. It's impossible. Yeah,
there ain't no demons.
Don't disturb the woods. I told you. He would come, and he would help. And he would laugh.
You told us.
Let's see what we figure out what this is all about.
Thank you. easy. Okay, then. Remember me? I helped with those dogs. I've been seeing about this curse of yours.
Welcome, brother.
It's a dark omen.
Those charms out in the woods, they all been broken.
All of them?
So I guess that's it for your suffering.
Ah! It's a miracle! We're saved! The darkness lifted!
Not saved.
Huh?
Cursed. He broke the charms. The spirits are set loose.
We're doomed then?
Hold on. You said the charms was protecting the curse.
I said it was a dark omen. I said he had the demon tongue.
Now, I need some light here. Now, I don't know what to think.
Hey, look at me.
Yeah?
I think something's going on in this holler. And it ain't a curse. And whatever else it ain't, this fella don't want you to know.
Liar! I told you he would lie and dissemble.
Something's up, and this one wouldn't be so quick with ideas he didn't have some clue of it.
I have the gift, my ancestor.
Well, I got a gift right here.
I'm going to commune with the spirits. Dark omens! Dark spirits!
What is he hiding?
He always spoke truthful to us. There is a dig on the other side of the hill there. There was a dig anyway. It's closed now. He always said something about not going over there.
Well, maybe I'll take a look at that dig. See if I can see something.
All right.
A squirrel, I thought. Look like a baby.
Time to go, boy. Slow it up.
This is the dig. Cursed, all right. Yeah. Who's there? I see you over there. The game's up. There's poison in this mine. Damn.
this, run off heading, huh? No! Oh, shit! Easy, easy.
I told you I would save you.
Yes.
Said I would lead you out of the darkness.
Yes, show us the light.
I shall. I shall. But first, you have to mark your signs on this paper. It's a powerful magic that will protect you on your journey.
I hereby release, absolve, and indemnify the aforementioned Roanoke Fuel Company.
Stop reading. Hmm? You didn't tell me you could read.
What kind of trick you pulling now?
Oh, you're back. We thought the curse had got you.
Nope, but he nearly did. Don't you go nowhere. I was down that old dig, and I found this leaking all the way into the lake. You've been poisoned.
No, we were warned not to heed what you
That's
say.
Right.
Well, let him tell you then. What's this?
It's nothing.
Nothing? Oh, then you won't mind taking a drink.
Hey,
no.
Hey,
no.
Hey,
no.
Hey, hey,
no. Hey, no. Hey, no. You've killed me. I'm poisoned.
Poison now, is it?
The dig. All they found was arsenic and lead. I dug down into the cave system and spread. I was meant to get you all to go.
Now you heard it.
It's taken me.
Oh, dear. Dear God. There's no arguing. It's clear as day. We're cursed.
Curse? What are you talking about?
My fucking God.
Powerful forces have taken on this town.
It ain't spirits.
Yes.
It's a mining company.
No, it is spirits. Spirits taken through a mining company. Brothers and sisters, we got some praying to do.
Don't pray. Do something. You'll die or worse.
Just go. It's our curse. It's ours to deal with. Now, the medicine man left some money there. Just take it if you want it.
go, boy.
Let's get the fuck out of here. Jesus Christ. Now, we're gonna go to Rhodes real quick. How the hell am I supposed to make it into Saint Denis when I'm wanted dead or alive, without cops seeing me, and complete this mission?
What do you need?
Thanks for stopping, sir. Thank you. Percy Whitsickle, Central Union Railroad Company. Maybe you can help me.
You and me both, partner.
One of my workers has been stealing wages. 3 weeks running. I have searched everyone and everywhere 10 times over. Of course, no one is talking. The way they look at me.
What's all this got to do with me?
I think I need someone a little more neutral. A little more persuasive. And you look like you're a... And I gotta watch the camp, so... Could you see what you could sniff out? I'll pay you for your efforts, of course.
Yeah, I got it. What exactly is it you want me to do?
Find the thief and recover the money. And give him his marching orders. I'm not one for matters of personnel. Look for anyone sneaking off the line. They've gotta be stashing it away from camp somewhere. Well, can you help me? My head is on the block here.
I'll see what I can do.
Thank you. Thank you.
No complaining. Just getting the job done. If you're gonna talk English. We offer you honest work for honest pay, and you steal from us. It's disgusting. Come on. Come on. What are you doing over here? What are you doing? All right, I gotta go for a piss. Y'all keep at it. I'll hear it if you don't.
What did Gizzy think about Anna?
You ready to return that money you stole?
Okay, okay. All right, all right. I'm leaving. The money is in the tree. Just don't kill me.
That was a fun little side quest. Good job, Arthur.
Hey, mister.
Terrible.
I got your money. Here. You're gonna need a new junior foreman, though. He just quit.
Randall? I don't believe it. Well, that does explain a few things. Thank you for your help, partner. Here. For your trouble.
That's pretty nifty.
More.
Kinda out of the way, kinda whatever.
Partner.
okay, boy.
Whoa.
That is not my custom outfit.
Your business. Hello, miss.
Money's blowing hard to get.
Thank you. Come on, pal.
I don't understand how I'm supposed to get into there. I mean, you're talking about... That's friggin'...
Okay. Trail. Trail's been here. Wow. Reckon I got away. Must be near.
Look at the fucking size of that thing. No, you don't just fuck it. What?
Come on now, boy.
Do not want to lose this.
Yep. Hey, mister.
Are there no law? Is there no law? Is that what I'm missing?
Hey, La, how things with you?
What are you two?
Well, shit the bed. Never thought I'd see the day La Cartis snapped his last. Tell your grandkids about this one, mister. Glad to see you again, sir.
Well, all right. Hello, little missy. This wheel is knocked down a tree. It doesn't seem like stopping anytime.
Welcome back, sir.
Hey, sir.
Oh, what do you have for me?
I'm still delivering late again.
Shoot. What? You mean I abandoned my legendary animal?
That don't surprise me one.
Okay, let's take a look at it. Nothing quite like wearing your best day's work.
Oh, fuck it, I don't know. I hunted the damn thing. I guess since I'm already here. I guess since I'm already here, I might as well just go over there and do the mission.
Easy now, partner.
Oh, come now. A hidden face implies a darkness beneath it. You are on thin ice with me. Let's do business, or you move on.
Hey, be careful. Don't you worry about me.
There you are.
Here I am.
Come on,
let's go. Let's go where? And why are you so riled up?
Today is a great day, Arthur. Today is the day they are going to hang Colm O'Driscoll.
That's so.
Rather they hang him or I shoot him.
Oh, they are gonna hang him.
Yeah, and not before time.
That boy's been on the gallows more than most. I wouldn't count anything until his neck's broke.
Well, nor would I. Which is why, despite us being wanted men, we're gonna attend the event ourselves.
And follow him onto the scaffold?
Well, let's hope not. But if I could see that son of a bitch breathe his last, I think I'd die a happy man. We are gonna disguise ourselves.
In this?
In this.
Mm. Even I get kind of frustrated by him.
Okay.
Come on.
Well, don't we just look the part?
We'll cut through the alley to get to the gallows. We keep our weapons holstered, our disguises on, and our wits about us.
Mrs. Adler, might I say, being a fancy woman of Saint Denis suits you.
I'd dress up like the Queen of Sheba if it meant seeing that son of a bitch swing.
Colm hung me up, nearly butchered me. I don't mean I'm comfortable in this woolen coat.
You made it out of that predicament, as I remember, Mr. Morgan. My husband weren't so lucky.
You lost your husband. I lost my darling Annabelle. That poor boy Kieran. We've all lost something because of Colm. And that is why we will shepherd him to eternity.
Amen to that.
Now keep those fingers off those triggers, because we'll need cool heads and calm dispositions to see this done.
Practice what you preach, brother.
Whatever do you mean?
Are you gonna keep your cool? Really? When you seem to lose it all so often now.
This doubting and questioning of yours? I miss the old Arthur.
Don't we all?
You two quit it. Y'all got a job to do. We're all in rough agreement about how we're doing it, as far as I can tell.
Exactly.
We'll get it done, all right.
All right, then. Come on. We got a hanging to witness.
Look here. Don't the public love an execution? Hey. Now, you see that pair of assholes?
Sure.
They're Colm's boys.
Yes, I think so.
What a surprise. I'm glad we're here. What are they pointing at?
I don't know. We gotta follow them and find out.
Yeah. Oh, here comes somebody. Stay here. go brush that horse, officer.
Yes, sir.
The crowd came to see a show. We don't want to disappoint them.
I guess they did miss their chance to see John swing by his neck.
Hey, hey, you know I wasn't going to let it come to that.
I guess I don't know what I know no more.
And I guess this isn't the time to question either my decisions or yours. Here and now, Colm O'Driscoll's going to get his due. He's turned down there. Let's go. Quiet.
What's it look like?
Bunch of cops.
Well, how many?
Enough. So what do you think?
Paul's up on the roof. Once he starts shooting, we have to have our wits about us and move fast.
Yeah. I guess we faced worse than this before.
Sure. Let's get to it.
Yeah.
So, they got a guy up on the roof, overlooking the gallows. Find a way up there, onto one of these verandas, through a building maybe, and get him. And do it silently.
Well, obviously, I'm gonna do it silently. I wanna see this bastard swing.
Oh, Arthur. Here's a ladder. Find a way up to the roof and stop him. I'll go back to Mrs. Adler.
Gallows. Which way was he?
To the left, Arthur.
Sometimes a man is so savage, the only way to deal with him justly is by savagery. Colm O'Driscoll is one such man. He has murdered, tortured, robbed, stolen, raped, and abused for a decade across five states. With impunity. Today, justice catches up with him.
As well you may. I've been a bad man.
Silence!
These charges.
This is not a court where you shall be tried. This is a place where your sentence is to be carried out, and your sentence, Colm O'Driscoll, is that you are to be hanged by the neck until you are dead. This is not a task we take lightly. It is not a task we enjoy. But it is a task we must carry out if our civilization is to prosper. Gentlemen, are we ready? Colm O'Driscoll, may God, in his infinite wisdom, have mercy upon your soul. Whenever you are ready.
Now you know how it feels to watch somebody you love die. You ruined my life!
Morgan! You hear us? Take a shot on these O'Driscolls!
And just like that, Como Driscoll is dead.
How you get on, Arthur?
Well, we saw the bastard hang okay, but no thing ain't gonna save us.
I guess that's one less thing to worry about.
I guess, compared to the entire government, in the end, Como Driscoll didn't seem like such a worry.
A letter came for you.
Oh, okay.
I know it's from that Mary.
Mary?
She ain't worth it, Arthur.
Who is?
My dear Arthur, you never showed up. And now, after looking at the newspapers, I understand why. I don't imagine you'll receive this letter, but I nonetheless must send it. Arthur. Oh, Arthur. I was just starting to dream the silliest and softest of dreams. I miss you, and I will always miss you. But I cannot live like that. And it seems you cannot live any other way. When I'm with you, the world makes sense. But when we are apart, I see clearly that your world is not a world from which one can escape. I'm so sorry. For everything long ago, and for starting up that business again. There's a good man within you, Arthur, but he is wrestling with a giant. And the giant wins time and again. You've broken my heart again, and I fear I have broken yours. And for that, I will never forgive myself, but you must let me go now. I enclose a ring you gave me many years ago, when we were both young. Not because I don't like it, but because I care for it far too much, and it reminds me too much of you. I hope one day you will find some people in love who can use this, for it kept me thinking of you all these years, and I hope by returning it to you, I can finally be free. Goodbye, Mary.
Might as well keep the reserves as full as we can. Thank you, Arthur. We should talk.
We got nothing to talk about.
Try to think for yourself for once in your goddamn life.
I don't want to hear it out of you, okay?
You think you're so clever, don't you?
You got such a chip on your shoulder, don't you?
But I see exactly what you're doing.
What's really the problem, Arthur?
Shut up. I don't want to hear it.
You're playing a dangerous game.
I see straight through you, Micah.
Keep this up. You'll see.
Open your eyes. We'll die if we stay here.
Dutch went and killed Cornwall and Annisburg. This'll be bad, John. Shit. Yeah. I'm worried he's coming unstuck.
Okay, well, let's talk more later.
All right then,
Arthur. Stay alert there, Javier.
Arthur. John.
Javier.
John?
Yeah, Micah.
Hey, John.
Alright.
Hey, darling.
Micah pushed me. Micah pushed me. Why is Micah still alive?
Yeah.
You came. You came. You finally came.
I came.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, you lovely, lovely man.
Calm down, miss.
Oh, come on. Let's go. We ain't got a minute to lose. They killed her. They killed Miss Calhoun. All she wanted was a better lot for women, and they killed her, those pigs.
Who killed her?
I don't know. My cousins, probably, or Bo's. Well, you met them. They are animals. Not even animals. Monsters. Monsters! If God had lost all his powers of imagination. Can you please take me to the train station? Bo'll be waiting.
Bo, why couldn't he come and rescue you?
Well, if they saw me and him together, they'd lynch him and send me off to a nunnery. Or maybe they'd lynch us both. I ain't quite sure. They do so love hanging folk.
Where are you heading?
Up to Boston.
Good. Yeah, I like you up there. Come on. Let's go.
Of course. I'm in your hands. Just get me to Rhodes Railway Station.
Okay. Let's try and get you a train. Bo's just waiting at the station. In the hope you'll show up, or I'll show up to help you show up.
He goes to there every day he can, makes up some excuse or other. I said he would see me there one day soon, and today he will. God willing.
Well, well. If he's there, that's true love, all right.
I've hardly seen him since the rally. They watched me so carefully, and he's waited, or... So his letters say, our families won't let us out. And then all that business with Aunt Catherine and my cousins. You saw the house. And then Lee Gray and those boys killed. So much bloodshed. You'd think this could be a new beginning, but everyone left alive. They're even more angry.
Maybe anger's a complicated thing to let go of.
Something good has to come out of this awful, awful feud.
That's what I've been hoping.
Bo and I have to be better. Our families were here for years and years. Sometimes I feel like we can't just leave death and pain and ruination behind us.
Plenty before you have. Plenty will again. But, yeah. As far as it goes, get out. Don't look back. Make something decent of your lives.
He's a good man, isn't he? Bo. There he is. Oh, it's him. Will you ride on the train with us a little, just to the first stop?
Fine.
Got the help talking about
you
that.
Came. You came! You came! At last you came!
Oh, Bo, my sweet, my best of men.
Oh, I'm hardly a man at all. But I love you, Penelope Braithwaite.
Can we get on the train now, please?
Sir. How can we ever repay your kindness?
By getting on the goddamn train.
Just fine.
Bo, Arthur's gonna join us. I think we need the support. Please, could you buy the tickets, dear Mr. Morgan?
Oh my God.
Being seen.
Sure.
Thank you. We'll meet you on the platform.
Can I have 3 tickets to Saint Denis, please, sir?
Of course. Oh. Hello, sir.
Hello, Alden. I hope all is well.
Not terribly, but good to see you.
Hey, cousin.
No. Oh, shit.
Hey, no, you ain't slow. Penelope, get back. Come on.
Excuse me, Alden. Get on the train. Get your bags, miss. I got this.
Come here, Yankee.
With pleasure, you goddamn fool. I don't want to come back here without giving you a whipping.
We should have done this last time.
Get on the train, folks. Go to your woman. Four fists and maybe one.
God damn it! Come on! Punch him, Arthur!
Get hurt, cowboy. Get him, Scott!
fucking pull out a pistol, please! God damn it.
Hello, future.
Almost.
All right, all done. That is quite a family you got there, son.
I know. Charming to the last. Then again, my uncle used to keep his own half-brother as a slave, so what do you expect, good manners?
My uncle used to say things were better the way they were, when he could rape and kill with impunity, and he didn't have to work a day in his life.
Both our families. There's good people in this county, but our families bully them and drove most of them off, whites as well as blacks, all over this silly feud.
Yeah, well, how to life.
Oh, my lord.
What? Oh, I think it's my second cousin.
What is with it with all these goddamn cousins?
I think they found out about the jewels.
All right, keep your heads down. I'll deal with this. Jewels? I knew you had some. Damn jewels. Oh, what the hell? You must have all the jewels. And the stately amount of your cousins is here.
Helping me!
Take a look up front.
What will you do?
I'll figure it out. Damn it, you did run. Remind me to rob your trains, mister. Man.
Oryx. Sounds like strawberry.
Have we stopped?
It's best you go on alone from here.
Mr. Arthur, I didn't know you could drive a train.
Neither did I. But if I'm honest, it was kind of fun. And I didn't kill any of us. Well, I killed some of your relatives, but they would have killed all of us.
You are a gentleman, sir.
Oh, no, I ain't.
Yes, you are. Here, I ain't got much money, but these sapphires are worth a lot of money. Old family heirloom.
That Braithwaite treasure. I couldn't take it. Now, let's get you off to Boston before any more of your relatives show up.
That might be wise.
Hey, you there.
Yeah?
This couple is heading up north to the Boston line. They got money, they'll pay you on arrival. That work for you?
Yeah, sounds fine. Get on in.
Hey, you carry protection on a journey like this?
I wouldn't be much of a stage driver if I didn't. Goes everywhere I do. Hey! Huh?
Miss Braithwaite is gonna hold on to this until arrival. Hmm? On account of the treasure on your person.
I don't know how to thank you.
You're a fine man,
you,
sir.
Just get out of here. I'll leave. Yeah!
Don't stop for anything. Rusty, you did follow me after all. Lottie freaking da. Who's a good boy? You're such a good horse, I love you. I think it's a good time to stop. I'm gonna just explore, so.